Welcome back to Shadow Hearts 2 Covenant. I've fixed the shadows, as far as the overworld goes. The combat's still going to be a little bit glitchy. There's not a whole lot I can do about that. If it gets really bad, I probably will change it back to the mode that's basically spits out exactly what the PS2 would. I don't want to do that, considering I've been fiddling with settings quite a bit to get it to look decent, so hopefully I won't have to do that. Anyway, tutorial number 2, let's learn about combos. This actually isn't too important at this point in the game, not to what I remember. The big thing is you gotta use it a lot for it to be good. I think. I'm not entirely 100% certain how a certain menu and something that says something has anything to do with it, but I think it does. High angle attacks, sure, why not? The game's going to automatically do some rings for me, which is fine. So it's not super demanding in its combos. The main point of this is to get a little bit of extra damage. It actually does add up after a while. Mostly a boss thing. Like that plus one, nah. But then again, at this point in the game, our damage output isn't really that high, so there's that too. Blah-de-blah-de-blah-de-blah-de-blah. It's just a system to add a little bit of extra damage, so you have the opportunity to think a little bit more about what you're doing in combat. That's all. And let's go for a standard hit, because, eh. Of course, he's not going to survive, but, you know. Again, not really a whole lot I can do about the, little graphical glitches in combat, or make the game look like crap, like that's my choices. But I cut out most of the combat, so it shouldn't be too bad anyway. So that's it for the combo tutorial. This place is very much a tutorial area. And let's actually show that thing I was talking about, Affinity. The max is 100. Because of that, I'm kind of leaning towards, you know, it's a percentage. You get 100% of the total that you're supposed to get. Now I'm getting 2%. I'm not... That sounds wrong at this point, but considering it goes to 1 to 100, 0 to 100, I think it's a percentage. Again, I'm not too sure. I don't know if anybody corrected me the first time I played this game, whether or not, you know, that was the actual thing. That's just what I think it is. Whether or not, again, if it is or not, I honestly don't know. But given the information I have, that's it. I should probably just look it up and see if I can find a definitive answer. That would be the best thing, RPG, but you're being lazy.
Many have been imprisoned and died here over the years. Noblemen who lost in battle. Tragic princesses who were thought to have died of illnesses. You can still feel their malice.
I knew it.
What is it?
I'm not sure. But when I met that demon in Dome Remy, I didn't sense the malevolence that I feel from the people in this tower.
Huh. Could it have been because you were so afraid then?
That may be part of it, but he was beautiful.
Interesting word to use.
Also.
Also?
He seemed sad.
Now that I've played the previous game, that whole sad line makes a little bit more sense now. Mana Leaf, your basic mana recovery item, of course. That's pretty much what we're expecting. However, this is less so a basic item. Hit area expand. The game hasn't explained to us what that is yet, and we actually can't even use it. So, let's just move on. The Ring Soul. This thing is going to show up quite a few times. And it's always good to see it. You must carry the burden of fate. You can see my future? That's a little worrying. Attack boost, which is a very nice item. The Judgment Ring, that's what we've been using to attack and eventually cast spells and etc. etc. Judgment Ring is basically 99% of what your combat is. There's nothing more to say. I am always watching. So, wait, the Ring Soul is Santa Claus, maybe? Then again, Santa Claus only really watches children, so there's that. It'd make it a little bit different. I am going to keep all that power to myself. Karen is a greedy, greedy person. No, we're going to skip that. That tutorial we're not looking at. Because it's probably going to make me do a whole bunch of stuff that I'd have to undo, and we're not going to do it. We're not turning on Auto Ring. There's a few ring types. Normal Ring, which we've been using. Practice Ring, which is exactly what it sounds like. Technical Ring, which makes everything smaller. And if you miss, the character skips a turn, which isn't really great. But you get a little bit more power out of it. Gamble Ring, which is the normal ring. It moves faster, and there's only one area. We're going to stick to the normal ring. Now, she'll get a third attack, Karen that is, but her first and last attack is going to be a little bit harder. It's worth it, though. Add-on effects, evasion down, it's very weak, probably never even going to work. Hit area. This is important. That hit area expand that I picked up earlier, that comes into play right now. And I think we can just put one strike area on both, all three of them. Good enough. So you can customize your ring a little bit. There's quite a few things you can do even at this point of the game, just at the start when you don't have a lot of this stuff. If you're really good at the game, go ahead and hit up the technical ring and do... I don't know if it has like a specific percentage extra damage, but it is significant, even at this point in the game. But again, you screw up, you don't get to have a turn, which is a little bit... nah. Let's use a tent. Why not? Eventually I'll be able to buy these anyway. And Karen, you haven't leveled. Normally you do so before now. That's fine. So we're still after that trinket that, Nikolai wanted. I'm gonna level right here, aren't I? Damn it's game, and I just used a 10. Now, if you happen to get a Ring Perfect victory, which I just managed to do, you do get a small bonus. Fairleaf, it's a basic healing item, but at this point in the game, that's a really good reward. If you take no damage, you get a little reward. If the enemy doesn't get a turn, you get a little reward. Don't expect insane things, but it's still nice to have. So the better you do, the easier the game will be. Okay. Not to mention, if you get like 75%, I think it is, perfect ring success, all the way to a certain point in the game, you'll actually get like this absurdly overpowered item. If you've watched Shadow Hearts, the first one, that's the one I'm talking about. The one I stopped using because it was so broken. Oh. Okay. as the first real boss, this is not really going to be much of an issue at all. It really isn't. Anyway, Nikolai has Blessed Light. This guy is darkness-based, so if I succeed, he's not going to live very long. Ah, damn it. I didn't get a perfect. That's fine. Obviously, getting a perfect success in a boss fight is definitely the way to go. Damn it. That's why you shouldn't blab when you're doing... you weren't blabbing. I'm not very good at Judgment Rings. I just want to say that right now. I just am not very good at Judgment Rings. I haven't played the game enough, really, to be that good. Also, you have 1 SP. That's bad. How much HP do you have left? Half. Oh well, we'll get to see, Karen go berserk. 3 extra damage. Woo. Actually... Nikolai, you can save Karen from being berserk, and we're going to do so. Pure Leaf. Thankfully, the game gives you 8 to start with, otherwise... Ugh. 3 SP, it's not a whole hell of a lot, but she only has a max of 4, so I don't think it's that big of a deal. Might want to heal Nikolai, but... I could probably get away with it. Probably. As long as I don't mess up.
Here it comes.
Oh, okay. And that's it. That's our first boss.
God grant them mercy.
And if you're fighting a boss and they only have a couple turns, you do get a bonus. 5 experience is not a whole hell of a lot. But considering it only took, what, like 15 for Karen to get to level 2? 46 to get up to level 4? That's not that bad. That's a nice little reward.
Is that it?
Yes. The ultimate tool for exorcising demons.
I love the fact that the game does reward you a little bit for playing extremely well. I think that's fantastic. Anyway, off the door, Remy. Dom Remy?
Don't worry. I've made the necessary preparations.
Preparations?
Yes.
Split up and surround the church!
You gotta remember, Karen is a lieutenant. She's not, you know, just a regular soldier. You know, she has a little bit of influence. However, we do need to pick up the chesty things. Mana Leaf. Sure, why not? There are a few items. It, again, it's the start of the game, but there's not going to be anything. Did I miss something? I feel like I've missed something. No, just the dead end. Oh, man. I want to get through this section of the game, because we're very much, you know, still doing the whole... Oh, new enemies. Doing the whole, you know, beginner area thing, and I want to get past it, but I'll have to wait. That's not going to help you, RPG. That's really not going to help you. I'm going for perfect rings because I do want the bonus, and honestly, I should practice them anyway. Come on, Karen. There we go, that's much better. We are literally fighting possessed toys. The enemy selection is in Shadow Hearts is absolutely fantastic, because, like, if you fight a demon, they look like a demon. They're not cartoony at all. It's the enemy design is literally all over the place. Like, right now we are fighting, you know, possessed toys. But it's absolutely wonderful. The enemies in this game are fantastically designed. Like, really, it's absolutely fantastic. Like, yeah, I'm fighting, you know, toys right now, but they're possessed demon toys. Later it's going to be, some of the bosses in this are absolutely wonderful, but, like, the first real big boss is creepy looking. You'll know what I'm talking about. Not the thing we just fought, I'm talking about afterwards. You'll see. Hi. I could sit here and grind because of you, but that's not really going to be something I'm gonna do. And another perfect ring victory. 12 cash. I started with 40, so again, it's very substantial. And all that is, you know, me playing well. I really like the fact that the game gives you rewards. Some of them are a little bit too powerful, I think, but, you know, 12 cash? That's not a whole lot, but I'm definitely going to be using that. And Karen is stuck, unfortunately. Nicholas is actually really close to leveling up, but if you notice, there's a little line. It's actually a tripwire when we get attacked by toys. Foolhardy little volunteers. That's a peculiar way to put it. Oh, Nikolai leveled. That's good. Level 4, 9 SP. Not too bad. A 10. Sure. Give me the item that recovers my HP at save points. Yes, please. I am. And let's be honest, if you have a free heal, are you just going to ignore it? I mean, honestly. I don't actually remember where all the items are, so yeah, I'm gonna fall for this. I'm just gonna fight the combats, because why not? That and getting money isn't exactly a terrible thing either. Karen's evasion down actually worked in that combat. That's surprising. Not like the enemies really avoid much at this point, but, you know, it's fine. Oh. Other than the demon and the wolf, I don't think so. And I don't think we can avoid this one. Oh, Karen leveled. Good. A little bit of extra cash from a ring perfect, too. Church isn't far now. No, it isn't. Domremy is actually a very small town in this game. Is there... Let's just save. Next time, more Shadow Hearts Covenant. Until then. I have a feeling that... Maybe it's just the fact that I've played so many games and there's been hidden items in graveyards. I might just think there's always a hidden item in a graveyard. Maybe, but I can't really go off the path. So... I don't know. Yeah, if I miss stuff, it's not really that big of a deal. No, this is next time. Stop game.